disappointing, but golly, that's bright. Welcome to Lakeway's 2023 Memorial Day ceremony. A lot of people nowadays are thinking that Memorial Day is about a mattress sale or perhaps a barbecue or time to get together and do something fun, and they forget to take a moment and really understand the meaning of Memorial Day. On a day like today, many folks will thank veterans for their service, but it's not about us. It's about those that can no longer wear the uniform. It's a solemn occasion to remember and pay tribute to those who paid the ultimate sacrifice in defense of our nation's freedom and values. It's time to honor those individuals who selflessly gave their lives. We want to take a special look a little later on at the meaning of a Gold Star family. Most of you probably understand there are Blue Star families. That's when you have someone in the family serving in active duty. Sadly, the Gold Star family is a family that has lost someone in combat. I'll address that a little later. Today's program is sponsored by the City of Lakeway, also the Standing Military Committee of Lake Travis. With that, I'd like to thank Jerry Schmeil up here in the front row. He helped coordinate the effort, put this whole program together. He may be small in stature, but by golly, his heart is about this big when it comes to community and when it comes to honoring veterans. So thank you, Jerry, for all you did in setting this up. I know you got a little nervous when I mentioned your name, but it was all good for the most part. Also, the Lowman's Four chapter of the Daughters of the American Revolution. We are pleased that Mike Hahn and the Lakeway Singers are here to perform our music. I think you're going to be very impressed. If you've not heard from them before, you are going to be very impressed. And they also hold functions at the community center from time to time. So keep an eye out for that, because it's pretty special to have these folks in our community. Before we begin the official ceremony, I'd like to extend a very big thank you to KJ Bartosh. He's the managing director of the Performing Arts Center. Look around at this facility. We always try to find a good location where we can bring everyone in to have a special ceremony, and I think looking around here, it's very special. And the students of Lake Travis High School who left school on Friday to start their summer, and by golly, they're here helping with lighting, setup, and sound. So thank you, KJ and the team, very much for that. At this time, if you are able, please stand for the Lake Travis Fire and Rescue Honor Guard, the presentation of colors, followed by the national anthem.
Thank you.
As I mentioned, Memorial Day is not about veterans or active duty. However, we always find it special when we have an opportunity to bring veterans together and recognize you for your service. So what we're going to do now is our service song medley. When you hear your song or hymn, please stand and be recognized for your service and sing along if you know the words.
United States Army. Marine Corps.
And most most of you are aware, we have a new branch, the Space Force. They're still working a few things out on that Air Force song. So Veterans Day, y'all will be singing the Air Force song. So that is another branch that we honor and recognize today. At this time, if you are again able, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance led by Alice Scarborough, Regent of Lomans 4, Chapter of VAR, followed by invocation delivered by Father David from the Emmaus Catholic Parish.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
God has set our nation among all others as a sign of his faithfulness. Let us give thanks to God for the blessings we have received from his hand. May we be ever more united as a nation of one mind and one heart. From the first letter of the Apostle Paul to the Corinthians, I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony of Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, you have placed us as a sign of unity. Look with favor on our nation. Receive the souls of our fellow citizens who have served this nation in the armed forces and who pass from this life in the line of duty. Enfold their families who remain in your protective care. May we be more of one mind and one heart in the bond of peace and know that you are the source and completion of every happiness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the City of Lakeway, our City Council, many of whom are here with you today, our City Manager and staff, I welcome you to this Memorial Day service. I want to thank our hosts here at Lake Travis High, and I want to thank each and every one of our participants, our guest speaker, who you'll hear from shortly, Rear Admiral Patrick Hall, U.S. Navy retired, Alice Scarborough, the Regent of the Lomans 4 Chapter of the Daughters of the American Revolution, who together with the Daughters of the American Revolution greet us at all of these events and hand out the poppies. Mrs. Kimberly Peacock, representing our Gold Star families, our trumpeters, Kate Caldwell and Josie Cowings, and our officiants, the very Reverend David and Deacon Terry. Finally, our appreciation for the service of the Color Guard of the Lake Travis Fire and Rescue, the Standing Military Committee for helping organize this, and our very own Lakeway Sing Hall. Today, I would like to ask you to accept three missions for this ceremony and this holiday. The first mission is for you to remain unwavering in your focus that this day is dedicated to those who gave all in the service of our nation. It is not just our privilege, but rather our sacred duty to remember the fallen. More than 700,000 Americans have died or are missing due to direct combat action. War is a terrible business. At some point, a command is issued, which sends men and women into the fight, and perhaps to their death, in order to accomplish an objective. The incredible thing is these warriors answer the call willingly, not for themselves, but for their brothers and sisters. Later in the program, we will hear taps, the traditional bugle call signaling the end of the day. However, taps, when played in the daylight, signals something entirely different. It is our acknowledgement of a fallen warrior. When you hear taps today, keep close in your heart the name of a fallen warrior. In my case, it will be my comrade and fellow graduate, Dick McAvoy, who was killed by a suicide bomber on August 22nd of 2015 at the age of 57 while serving in Afghanistan. The second mission I have for you is to remember the families and brothers in arms of the fallen. As noted by a group dedicated to remembering the fallen, a group Honor and Remember, today is the most expensive holiday on the calendar. Every hot dog, every burger, every spin around the lake, or drink with family and friends is a debt purchased by others. This is not about all who've served. This one is in honor of those who paid in life and blood, whose moms never saw them again, whose dads wept in private, whose spouses raised kids alone, and whose kids only remember them from pictures. This isn't simply a day off. It is a day to remember that others paid for every free breath you get to take. Please keep close in your heart both the families and those who served with the fallen. And our final mission today is to have a happy Memorial Day. In this mission, I quote from my friend, Vincent Brooks, General United States Army retired, who spoke to us 2 years ago on this occasion. He asked, how does anyone say happy in front of Memorial Day? And then he answered, there are reasons to be happy. Be happy to be an American. Be happy that America is the land of the free because of the brave. Be happy that our nation produces some amazing people, even when some of them never come home. Be happy to feel the heavy weight of the sacrifices and also the weight of a greater obligation to live a life worthy of their sacrifices. And be happy that every generation of Americans has answered the call and will continue to do so. God bless the fallen. May he bless you all. Thank you for attending today.
Thank you, Mayor Kilgore. I think to put Memorial Day into a bright light to truly understand is to address the Gold Star family. Today, we are honored to have Kimberly Peacock with us. She's a Gold Star widow. I want to tell you a little story here that I think will really, again, shed light. The story of Major John Gillespie, known as his friends as TJ. TJ joined the United States Army in June of 83. He completed residency at the Brook Army Medical Center at Fort Sam Houston, was a board-certified anesthesiologist, and served at numerous Army locations around the world. He met Kimberly and when he was assigned in Korea. They were married December of 1989 and began their life together at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. A few of us have been there. Just a few months later, if you recall, August 1990, TJ was called up to deploy to Saudi Arabia in preparation for Desert Shield, Desert Storm. He was a part of the 28th Combat Support Hospital, and he was stationed in Dahran. He volunteered his off-duty time in pediatric anesthesiology. So he wasn't resting, he was helping and honoring those individuals that he was with, both civilian and military. As the ground war became imminent, the 28th moved forward to support the troops and prepare for that front line to move quickly. Early one Sunday morning, TJ volunteered to join the medical supply convoy to assist with the moving of necessary supplies and support of the operating room, and to have an opportunity to call his young bride to wish her a late happy Valentine's Day. The convoy didn't make it to its destination, and February 17th, 1991, TJ paid the ultimate sacrifice for our country. Again, that puts into perspective why we're here, why we are honoring those that are not here. And 32 years later, his loss is still felt in the hearts of family and friends, and they are grateful for a nation that will commemorate Memorial Day and ensure that he and those that have given all are not forgotten. And I think going forward, we're not going to forget about TJ. It sounds like a special individual. And speaking with Kimberly over the past couple of weeks and talking about TJ, it sounded like a very special individual that I'm honored to be able to tell his story. At this time, we're going to have the presentation of the memorial wreath. That will be conducted by Miss Kimberly Peacock as well as Alice Scarborough. For our special guest speaker, as an individual I met last year, he's a Lakeway resident. I am honored as a lowly former captain in the United States Army to be able to introduce him, and he even said I can call him by his first name, Pat, which for an admiral is pretty special. Thanks, Pat. But Pat, again, retired Admiral Patrick Hall, call sign Monty. Monty Hall. He was the captain of the USS Abraham Lincoln. He was the commander of the USS Ronald Reagan Strike Group. He has over 900 carrier landings. He's a Top Gun pilot. He flew F-14s. This is getting long, Pat. I don't know. He also led a combat team, a team of aircraft into combat. And I'm honored to call him my friend, and I'd like to bring him up for him to address the audience. Admiral Hall.
Thank you, Steve. Thanks for the introduction, and thanks for all of you that are attending here today. It's both an honor and a privilege to be with you on Memorial Day. And as already been pointed out, this is about those who have fallen in service to our country. You know, when I think about Memorial Day, I have two thoughts that come to mind. The incredible sacrifice some veterans have made in service to our country. And two of my friends that I remember who passed away during their service to our country. One was Bob Matheny, and the other one was Glenn Hansen. One passed away in an airplane crash, and the other one passed away from cancer, all while in service. Neither one were overly heroic people, but they did it and they served because they believed in what they were doing. Serving their country, and that had meaning and was important, and that in itself gave meaning to their life.
Their deaths were in service, and I always think about them on Memorial Day. So I will not forget. I ask you to think about who caused you to come here today and attend this service. May they rest in peace, knowing they left this country and the world in a better place. We will not forget. In America's cities and towns today, flags will be placed on graves and cemeteries. Officials will speak of a sacrifice and the valor of those in the memory we honor. In 1863, when he dedicated a small cemetery in Pennsylvania, marking a terrible battle between the armies of the North and South, President Abraham Lincoln noted the swift obscurity of such speeches. Well, we know that Lincoln was wrong in this case about that particular occasion. His remarks commemorating those who gave their last full measure of devotion were long remembered. But since that moment at Gettysburg, few other addresses have become part of our national heritage, not because of the inadequacy of the speakers, but because of the inadequacy of our words. We will not forget. You know, I have no illusions what little I can do to add to the silent testimony of those who gave their lives willingly for their country. Words are even more feeble on this Memorial Day, for the sight before us is that of a strong and good nation that stands in silence and remembers those who were loved and who in return loved their countrymen enough to die for them. We will not forget. Yet we must try to honor them, not for their sakes alone, but for our own. And if words cannot repay the debt we owe these men and women, surely our actions, we must strive to keep faith with them and with the vision that led them to battle and to final sacrifice. We will not forget. Our first obligation to them and ourselves is plain enough. The United States and the freedom for which it stands, the freedom for which they die, must endure and prosper. Their lives remind us that freedom is not bought cheaply. It has a cost. It imposes a burden. And just as they whom we commemorate were willing to sacrifice, so too must we. In a less final, less heroic, but be willing to give of ourselves, because we will not forget. It is this, beyond the controversy and endless congressional debates, beyond the blizzard of budget numbers, debt ceilings, and the complexity and cost of our modern military weapon systems, that motivates us in our search for security and peace. The willingness of some to give their lives that others may live never fails to invoke in us a sense of wonder and mystery. One gets that feeling at ceremonies like this on Memorial Day. I've had a similar feeling at sea on Memorial Day, and at Arlington National Cemetery, or the Tomb of the Unknown Soldiers, or any of our national cemeteries. That same poignant feeling as I look out across a row of white markers. Each one marks the resting place of an American hero. The heroes of World War I, the GIs of World War II, Korea, Vietnam, Iraq, Afghanistan, and the never-ending global war on terrorism. They span several generations of young Americans, all different and yet all alike. Like the markers above their resting places, all alike in a truly meaningful way. We will not forget. As we honor their memory today, let us pledge that their lives, their sacrifices, their valor, shall be justified and remembered for as long as God gives life to this country. And let us also pledge to do our utmost to carry out what must have been their wish, that no other generation of young men and women will ever have to share their experiences and repeat their sacrifice. Again, thank you for the opportunity. God bless you and the United States of America, and I will never forget. Thank you.
We'd like to thank you not only for being here today, but for your service to our country.
Thank you.
Thank you, Admiral. We're coming to a close of the ceremony. Just one item that I want to point out. It is refreshing to see kids in the audience, and they're behaving very well. I'm part of Honor Flight Austin, where we take veterans to our memorials in Washington, D.C., and I've been to the wall over 60 times with Vietnam veterans. And at the Korean War Memorial, there is words in the granite. I feel those words should be in every school, every church, every public place. And those words are, freedom is not free. And the meaning is, we fought for that freedom. And there are, as the mayor said, quite the headcount of Americans that died for that freedom. So for the youngsters, remember that. Freedom is not free. It was paid for by the blood of Americans. For our values and for our country and for our citizens. So thank you for bringing the youngsters out. Definitely appreciate that. I think it's a really nice perspective. At this time, we would like to have our singers present us with a God Bless the USA, please.
Next to you, and you're still, and there ain't no doubt.
right. Actually, if you'd please remain standing for the benediction performed by Deacon Terry Gilbert.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we pause at the close of this Memorial Day service to acknowledge again your sovereignty over our lives and our country. We continue to pray for our fellow servicemen and women who have departed this life. We honor them for their loyalty to God and country, and for their good deeds, and for their friendship. May they rest in peace, and may the good works you have begun in them be brought to perfection, that our nation may be strong and our people secure and happy. May the loved ones and dear friends of these most honorable men and women continue to cherish their memories and accept their great sacrifice in peace. May we be joined together in the common goal of service to our God and our country. Let us depart this Memorial Day service in peace and in love and charity with our neighbors. Be with us and bless us with your mercy as we return to our homes. We ask this of you and give you praise, honor, and glory in the precious name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us swear to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair. As we raise our voices in a common
said, please be seated. As the mayor said, when you're at fourth or bass, they do play taps to retire the colors. But when you hear taps during the day, it's for something very, very special. And I'm sorry, that one got me. That was beautiful. Thank you so much. We're coming to a close. Again, thank you for coming out. Following the ceremony, I would like veterans in the room, as well as Purple Heart recipients who are veterans, if you could please come forward. We'd like to talk to you about our special 4th of July event and Veterans Day. So if you come forward following this ceremony. Thank you for joining us today. I think everybody came in with a clear picture of what is Memorial Day that through this ceremony and the Admiral's speech and Mayor Kilgore and Kimberly, our Gold Star widow. It paints a very graphic photo of what truly is Memorial Day. And thank you. Remember, freedom is not free. And I don't think we're going to forget TJ anytime soon. It's an individual who's going to stay with me for quite some time. So this time, if you please rise and we'll retire the colors. Heart recipients over here and our veterans, please approach over here. Very much appreciated. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Thank you for coming to honor the fallen. Have a great day.